Hello, I'm going to be showing you how to do binary addition in this video. Then we'll look at a concept of an overflow error towards the end. So if you know how to do binary addition already, you may want to skip ahead to the overflow error bit. But let me show you how we do this first in case you're not sure. So you should hopefully know by this point how to do addition in deanery. We line up our two numbers like here, and then we do it column by column. So 5 plus 5 is 10, but I can't write down 10 because I carry into the next column. So I write down a 0 and I carry a 1 across. 7 plus 1 is 8, plus 4 is 12. Again, I write down a 2 and I carry a 1. 9 plus 1 is 10, plus 1 is 11. I write down a 1, I carry a 1, and so I end up with this being my final answer. So because it's deanery and we've got 10 digits, if I add up a column and it goes beyond 10, that's when we carry, and we carry a 1 across. It's the same idea in binary, except that we are carrying when we go beyond 2. So here is a typical question. You get given two binary numbers and you are told to add these up. You could convert to deanery, add up, and then convert back to binary, but that's not how you're meant to do it. You're meant to leave it in binary and add it up using the method I'm about to show you. It can be helpful to learn carry rules for binary, so learn when to carry and when not to carry. The first three here are barely even worth learning because it's just basic maths, right? 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 0 is 1. That's all pretty straightforward. The bottom two of ones which are worth learning potentially, because when I've got 1 plus 1, that is 2, but I can't write down 2 because 2 doesn't exist in binary as a digit. Instead, I write down a 0 and I carry a 1. When I've got 3 ones in a row, I write down a 1 and carry a 1. And let me show you this in action. I've picked a deliberately easy first example. If it doesn't put it lined up for you, you need to do this. And be really careful that it's lined up in the same way you would do with deanery. So if I've got a mismatch in how long one of the numbers is, you always start on the right-hand side. You don't start writing on the left-hand side. It needs to be lined up on the right. I would do a little line at the bottom. I'll do a plus to the side like you would in deanery. And then we can do our addition. This one's very easy because it only sticks to our first three rules. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. And 1 plus nothing is just 1. So that is our answer. You could convert to deanery and check it's all correct if you had time in an exam. Here is a second example, which is a little bit longer and we'll need some carrying. So my second number here is bigger than my first number. So personally, I would always write the biggest number at the top. I would do that in deanery as well. So let me line up as best I can. I must say a big error is people lining up this wrong, often due to rushing, often due to bad handwriting. And I'm definitely vulnerable to this as well. So you have got to concentrate when you do it and make sure you can clearly see which column is where. Do my line, let me do my plus. So now 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1, however, we need to use our carry rule. So 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. And if you want to know why that's the case, well, 1 plus 1 in deanery is 2, but we haven't got 2 as a digit. So what is 2 in binary? Well, 2 in binary is 1, 0. If you can imagine our place value columns, this is 1 and this is 2. So 2 in binary is 1, 0. And that 0 goes beneath and that 1 goes into the next column being carried across. Now I've got 1 plus 0 plus 1. I can effectively ignore the zeros. So 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. And the rest of it is pretty simple. So that is our answer for this second example. This third example, we're going to use our triple carry. So perhaps pause and have a go, especially if you know how to do this already. These numbers are both 8 bits. Let me copy them out. Okay, so 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 0 is just 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. And then 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 1, carry 1. So that should be our answer. Again, this is because 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3, but I haven't got access to 3 as a digit. So we have to write 3 in binary, which is 1, 1. So one of those 1s goes beneath, one of those 1s gets carried into the next column. That's why this rule is how it is. Now, this third and final question could potentially give rise to something called an overflow error. It might not, but it could potentially give rise to it. Often, this is a follow-up question to a question where they get you to actually do binary addition. So, overflow errors all relate to memory. Here is a stick of RAM. It's one of our memories in a computer. And computers only have a limited amount of space in memory. We've got maybe 8 gigabytes of RAM. I haven't got an unlimited supply of memory, which creates problems because if a calculation results in a number that is longer than there is space available, you're going to get an error. And this error is called an overflow error. The example I just showed you resulted in there being a 9-bit answer when both of the inputs were 8-bit. If I only had 8 bits available in memory, I cannot store that 9th bit, which is where the error is created. So to hopefully give you a slight way to visualize this, let's say this is a kind of cross section. It's part of our memory. Well, perhaps the orange part here is the end of a homework Word document. And perhaps the purple bit here is the start of Windows being held in memory. And let's say this blue bit is where our result from binary addition is going to get saved. Well, if I was to do addition like this, I can store it in memory because despite my 2 inputs being only 4 bits, the output is 5 bits. But if I've got 5 bits in memory, that's absolutely fine. So I'll not always get an overflow error. This has carried beyond my far left bit, but I don't necessarily get an overflow error. I only get an overflow error if I've not got space for it. Here, I do have space for this result. However, this won't always be the case. Here is an addition which also carries beyond what it had originally, but it results in 6 bits. If I've only got space for 5 bits in memory, what do I do? Well, I could try and put all 6 here and maybe override part of the memory to the left, but that's going to corrupt this file potentially. So usually that won't happen. One of the ways this can manifest itself is that I put in the number, but I just cut off my far left bit. You know, I put in the bits I can and have to cut off bits which I haven't got space to store. Now that's a massive problem because this number happens to be 39. The result should be 39. But when I cut off that 1 on the left-hand side, this gives me 7. So the answer should be 39, but I save 7, which could be catastrophic for your program. It could cause it to crash. It could cause quite a difficult error to resolve. It could really affect your user because it's just not being saved correctly. Now, the reason why overflow errors can be particularly problematic is because they affect what is called the most significant bit. The far left bit in a binary number is called the most significant because its place value is the biggest. It has the biggest impact on the number. The far right digit only ever represents the place value 1. So losing that far right digit is not really a problem. However, losing the far left digit, the MSB, the most significant bit, is a massive problem. That's why we've gone from 39 to 7, because we lost the 32, which is representing that place value at this position. So our far left bit is our most significant. That's often the most vulnerable when it comes to overflow errors because we haven't got space to store it.